See? Brand new, all wood.
Look at that, huh? Flammable?
Gentlemen, please. There will be plenty of time for dental inquiries after this session.
Apologies.
Right. We have been gifted with the monumental task of deciding for the great and future generations of our experimental nation just exactly how to refer to, should they arise, bizarre and experimental sexual situations.
Yes, and why?
So that our brethren will not succumb to such asinine quarreling of such pointless of a topic as to distract them from bettering what we have created here in our new world.
Aye, and how many of these possible scenarios must we consider?
We must consider all of them, so that no time will be wasted on them in the future. I fear, gentlemen, if we fail here today, the future of this nation will be one of young men indulging heavily in spirits, becoming uncomfortably close with other young men. Talking about perverse topics and experiencing great enjoyment from topping the last one with an even more grotesque scenario. Whilst women seem to share these humorous sentiments, they secretly despise such conversation, plotting amongst each other how to overthrow this great nation of men under God.
Right. Well, we better get started then.
Here, here.
First order of business. Our founding brothers have requested that we come up with a title for this esteemed committee.
It should be so suitable as to echo greatness through the archives of time, and also the archives.
Having been given forth knowledge of this request, I believe I already have, with much deliberation with my wife, found a suitable title. Ready for this shit? The proper usage of selective slang for the youth committee.
Oh.
Ah, pussy it shall be. All those in favor, knock wildly on the table. Let the record show that pussy shall dominate the proceedings with an official title having been passed.
Hear, hear.
For efficiency purposes, proper usage of the selective slang for the youth shall henceforth be referred to as pussy in this and all following committees.
Aye.
I have here the findings of an exploratory committee predating that of the pussy today. The People's Executive and National Internal Societies Committee. Our sister committee has painstakingly come up with a list of all these experimental situations. Number one, a sexual act in which a man stands with his feet and knees bent, shoulders width apart, exposing his anus to his partner by spreading his butt cheeks while she performs analingus, whilst taking the hands past the balls onto the shaft and performing an up and down motion like so.
Intriguing.
This up and down motion of such a shaft reminds me of a trombone.
Why, yes, indeed it does.
Perhaps we could incorporate the word trombone to describe such a reach around.
The whole act seems too dirty to describe. The smooth, polished skills of a trombone player's lips blowing towards the up and down motion of musical harmony.
What if, per se, the trombone was old and rusty?
A rusty trombone?
A rusty trombone. All those in favor?
My mother suggests this endeavor would be horrible, but is actually quite fun.
Indeed.
Make it clear in the ledger that all acts of such natures will henceforth be called rusty trombones.
Now, gentlemen, I was perusing these findings one fortnight, and while it would appear that our sister committee has gone through great lengths to consider all possible acts, I do feel that it is my duty to reveal one that I believe they may have missed.
By all means, man, continue.
Well, let us consider that in all hypotheticalness that I would be making love with a woman that wasn't my wife on a nice sandy beach, because of course my wife would not allow this. So, there I am, in the hypothetical act of adultery on a beach. In throes of rapid passion, I accidentally extend too far back in the backwards half of a full thrust motion. And I am required to reconstitute my previous gains. Since my doggedly position was established, I had not considered what to do if I was to lose my footing. My lack of forethought has unfortunately given me trip into the coarse sand below. Undaunted by this and a desire of more, I reestablished my original footing, much to the dislike of my passionate partner.
Apologies, but I don't follow.
My wet junk fell into the sand.
Ouch. Would it not be proper then to refer to this as a breaded chicken cutlet?
Ooh!
Gentlemen, gentlemen, you must be proper before you pop her.
Yes.
What next on the list?
Number two, an unintentional mustache created by improper or perhaps unwise exiting from one orifice to another, namely transferring from anus to mouth with said member.
I see. This does seem to be a difficult one.
So that I'm clear, we are referring to a fecal mustache?
We are indeed, sir. We are indeed. Ah, Sanchez, what say you of such perplexion?
That's it. A dirty Sanchez.
Oh!